Hi, this is Karim Backwards, and in this video I'd like to show you how to create your own or upgrade hard drive in your Xbox 360 E or S generation. I mean these generations. This is, for example, Xbox 360 E, and this is the hard drive we are talking about, or Xbox 360 S. The hard drive itself looks like this. Inside there is a 2.5 inch HDD hard drive that you know from older laptops. But unfortunately, Microsoft doesn't allow you to use any of hard drives to put it in and make it as an Xbox official hard drive. In comparison, PlayStation 3 allows you to do anything, but Microsoft with their Xbox doesn't. So now I will show you how to use any Western Digital hard drive to be able to use it on your Xbox 360. So you will need three things. The thing number one is the HDD case for your hard drive. You can buy it, for example, on AliExpress. It's just a piece of plastic. It's an empty HDD case and it's pretty cheap. It looks like this. As you can see, it's an empty case for your future hard drive. And you will put the 2.5 inch HDD inside this case and put a cover on it. Second thing you are going to need is to be able to connect your hard drive to your PC. There are two options. The best one, if you have a desktop PC with a free SATA slot, you can use it and put it directly into your motherboard or into your SATA connectors. But if you have a laptop, then you will need something like this. This is a converter from USB to SATA connector. Please do not buy the cheapest one you will find. It might not work properly. I recommend at least the one which has a power adapter included. You will probably not need it to power up these 2.5 HDDs, but it's always useful to have it. And the third thing, of course, is a hard drive as itself. The process I will show you today is compatible with only Western digital hard drives. Even there is a lot of discussions that only some of these models are supported for this process I will show you. It is not right, and you can use almost any of WD hard drives. And one more thing, everything what we are going to do doesn't require JTAGing or hacking or any other modifying of your Xbox 360. So no soldering, no hacking is needed and so on. So let's get into it. Primary, you will need a FatXPlorer application. Put into Google FatXPlorer and hit enter, and you should get something like this as a result. So go to this page, to the download section, and download the newest one version of the FatXPlorer you can find here. You can even use a beta version. So let's download it, open it, unpack it, and just run it. There are two important informations. If you will see down here the notification about new update, so please update it. Just do it. And the second thing is about the driver. You don't need the driver to be installed. It will be necessary, for example, if you will want to copy an existing data from the Xbox 360 hard drives to your computer. But this is not our case today. We are going to create a new clean one hard drive to be compatible with non-hacked Xbox. Now connect the hard drive to your computer. By the way, I think it's obvious, but just for sure, we are going to lose any data on the hard drive because we are going to format it and so on. So if you have some data on it and you don't want to lose them, just back it up somewhere because we are going to wipe all data on this hard drive. Okay, now what we're going to do is to click here on the Xbox 360 HDD Maker. In the next step, you have to choose the correct hard drive you want to format to be compatible with your Xbox 360. In my case, it is this one. You can double check that the manufacturer of the hard drive is Western Digital, which is obvious from the model number, which begins with WDC. So you can use it as a check if you have a correct hard drive chosen. Now the next step is to click on backup and flash. And now what we're going to do is we have to modify the firmware of the Western Digital hard drive. And at first, just for sure, it has to be backupped. You will probably never need it, but it's a necessary step, so let's do it. So click on OK and save the backup firmware somewhere into your computer. Now wait a few seconds and the hard drive has been just flashed. It means that the firmware of the hard drive has just been modified to be compatible with the Xbox 360. This is a necessary step which has to be done to make the Xbox 360 detect your hard drive. Now the next step is that you need to format it. So let's click on Format HDD now. And again, choose the same device you have chosen before updating the firmware and click on Next. Now, this is very important screen. You always want to see the message like this, that it has a valid matching security sector. Because if you will see here a message which will tell you that the security sector has not been found on disk, it's a problem and you will not be able to use the hard drive in your Xbox until you will hack your Xbox. I will show it later. But now this is a good news and we want good news. So click on Next. This, just leave it as it is. Do not change anything, do not click on anything, and just click on Next. Now you can put down a label name of your hard drive, and this label will be visible in your Xbox. So we can put in something real or relevant. So for example, I like this kind of format of a label, because when you will open it in your storage devices in your Xbox, you will immediately see the capacity of your hard drive. Now, after clicking Next, just again keep it as it is and click Next again. Now double check that you have here the quick format checked and click on Format. Now it will take a few seconds and your hard drive is ready. Click on OK and safely remove the device. Now, after disconnecting, we can put it into the HDD case we have bought before. It's very easy. Just remember that this SATA output has to be in the same way as this hole in the case. So you will put it just like this inside. As you can see, the hole in the case is now filled with the SATA ports. So just do not put it in opposite way. Now, the next thing is to put on the cover in the correct way. The correct way, what I mean is that you have to take a look on the cover and you will see that it's not an symmetrical in the meaning of these clips. So easiest way how to find the correct way how to put it on the case is that you will find the shorter side with the clips on it. Because as you can see, this shorter side has two clips but the other one doesn't. So this side goes above the SATA connector. So if you have this, where here is the SATA connector, so you want to put the SATA connector down here, like this. It even is obvious, if you will take a look on it, you will see a small holes here for these clips. So just please remember that there is only one way how to do it correctly and that you don't want to put it on it incorrectly. Because using your force, you will be able to put it in, but you will never be able to open it again and it will look deformed. So that's what you don't want to. Now I'd like to show you the issues I have mentioned before. Issue number one, you are trying to connect hard drive which is not manufactured by Western Digital but by another developer. Now, for example, as you can see, I'm trying to connect Hitachi hard drive, but as you can see, FatXPlorer tells me that it cannot be used and the process cannot be even finished. So this is how it looks when you are trying to connect anything else than WD. The second issue I mentioned before was about the security sector, because sometimes you can get this kind of message that the security sector doesn't match information reported by the firmware. This usually happens when you have your Western Digital hard drive physically damaged. For example, like some bad sectors or the electronics is almost dead and so on. So this is not a usual message. Anyway, you can finalize it, but you have to remember that if you will ignore this message and continue, this hard drive will not be detected by your Xbox until you hack it or crack it or anything else. But as I mentioned before, we do not want to hack our Xbox to be able to read our hard drives. So for us, this is a no-go and we can only cancel. Okay, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video, that it helped you, and I would really appreciate if you give me a subscribe or the thumb up, and if you will have any issues, just put it down into the comments and I will try to help you. Thank you very much again for watching this video and see you again later. Goodbye.